Hi, welcome to another ESP32 tutorial by RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how we can use the LCD screen of 1602 or LCD 2004 with ESP32 microcontroller, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi unit. We're going to display the text or numbers. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. These are the ESP32 development boards with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And they are offered in different formats. For example, if you compare these two, you will see what one is shorter, the other is longer, or you might see it something as a shield like this. This is the same ESP32 room 32, or maybe completely different, something like this, which I have separate video on that. And the code and explanation that I will work with this LCD screen. This has 16 characters and 2 line with I2C module at the back, so it has only 4 wires. Or if you have 2004, which has 4 line and 20 characters, this one also has an I2C module at the back, as you can see both of these. So the code will work exactly the same, and this needs 5 volts to operate. These two needs 5 volts to operate, and you have to get 5 volts, which I'm going to show you next. Let me now explain this module. I have a separate video explaining it with full details of I2C communication is attached and soldered. When you purchase it, they send this separate with this, or it is soldered and sent. So make sure to get the one that is already ready, so you don't have to spend any time on that. There are 4 pins for ground, VCC, SDA, and STL. These two are for I2C communication. This is a chip for I2C communication that gets the data with some other components, so it can go to this LCD. Otherwise, you have to connect this many wires, which is very hard. And then the contrast of this can be adjusted using this. Contrast of this. If I bring this up, you see it's completely disappeared the text, but if I go this way, it will be too much dark, so you have to find somewhere in between those two so you can read it. And if you disconnect this, the light will be turned off. It's like that. Connecting a voltmeter here so you can see the voltages. I'm connecting the ground pin, the negative pin, to the ground here, and the positive, which I've connected a red one. If I connect it to this point, which is 3.3 volts, labeled as 3.3 volts, you will see that we are getting 3.3 volts. But the LCD will not be turned on with this 3.3 volts. We need 5 volts. And the only pin that has that 5 volts is this last pin, which has been labeled as 5 volts in this module. And this is now 5 volts. This is a 5 volt that is coming from USB and immediately exiting, and then it goes to this 3.3 volts, which gives power to the rest of the board. A separate video explaining that. Now, if you are connecting external power, then you need to connect 5 volts here, and from the same wire connected to your LCD. So this will not be available to you. And if you have this module here, you see these two are different in terms of length, and this has not been labeled as 5 volts, but it's labeled as VN. Let me show you. Let me connect this to the ground. Where is ground? In here. And let me connect the positive to this pin, and now it shows 4.6, a little drop, but still it will work. So this is with a little voltage drop that due to this Schottky diode that is here, it's being reduced 0.4 volts, and that is the 5 volts that will work with the LCD. And then 3.3 volt is at this point, point. So depending on the module, make sure that you can get 5 volts, otherwise the RCD will not work. The wiring diagram for this project is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. The link will be available below this video. Let me explain the wiring. And here for the wiring, I've prepared this so you can see it easily. SCL is this pin, pin 22. If it is labeled D22 or 22, that's a pin. SDA is pin 21. And here on this module, it has been labeled as G22 and G21. There is RX, TX in between. And if you're getting a different module like this, again, here it says D22 and here D21. Ground from this side is connected using this brown wire to the ground. Doesn't matter which ground you have, but in this module, this ground does not work. When I use the continuity tester, it fails. So this is a ground when I connect it. And the next one is VCC. VCC needs 5 volts, and this module has 5 volts at this pin. SDA is orange. This has been connected to pin 21. And here. And SCL is yellow. It has been connected to pin 22. If you need to connect multiple devices that need I2C communication, because we have 2 pins, bring a jumper wire here, and from here you can distribute it to up to 128 devices. Keep that in mind. Let me explain the code. You need to download this liquidcrystal_I2C library. I will provide you the link. So you have to download it. When you download it, it will be a zip file. Save it in your computer. Then go to Sketch, include library, add.zip library, and then to point it to where you have saved it. For example, if this was your library that you have downloaded for liquidcrystal.zip, select it and click open. Once that is open, then the library will be ready. And this example, you will copy and paste it, and it will work. So we include this header file, which is part of the library. And after that, in this line, we create an instance of this class, and we call it LCD. And we are passing 3 parameters. This one, the first one is 3F. The 0x means hexadecimal. And this is an address for I2C. How you get this one is that I will provide you the I2C scanner. And this is the I2C scanner. We do not worry what is inside it. The original link is here. If you want it, just upload it to your module. My module is already connected. I'm uploading it. Opening the serial monitor by clicking Tools, Serial Monitor, or you can press Ctrl+Shift+M. Make sure to set your serial monitor with the same baud rate, otherwise you will not be able to see it. On the right side and the lower corner, go to 9600 and wait. You see it reading it 0x3f. 3f is the address, and it continuously doing the same thing. Close this and then close I2C scanner. So we got our address, and I've already printed here so I don't forget it. We have 16 characters here and 2 line, so that's why we put 16 and 2. This count is just for the counting of this number. Do not worry. We are initializing the serial monitor. We are initializing the screen by using lcd.begin, because we have created an object for the screen. This is initializing it. This is setting the backlight on, and this is just printing this text on the screen. If I press this reset button on that side, you will see that the demo and this text are shown at two lines. So we are using lcd.print to print this text inside that double quotation. You see, it is printing the text, and then we set the cursor at character 0, line 1. So we are moving to this character, character 0, line 1. This is line 0, that is line 1, and we print the text demo. Let me bring it again so you can see it, demo. And then we wait for 2 seconds so the user can see it. Inside the loop, we clear the screen from previous value because the loop will continuously print something. And then LCD print, we print this text. This text is printed from there. If we don't say set cursor 0, 0, automatically it goes to cursor character 0, line 0. That's why we didn't use set cursor at the beginning. But after this, because if you don't put this, this text will go at the end and will be over the previous value or out of the screen. So we set this so the cursor moves to the next line and it prints this counting with a colon. This is the text. After that, we set cursor to character 11, line 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We go to character 11, line 1, that is line 0, line 1, and then we print this count. Count is a number that is being incremented every 200 milliseconds. So this loop prints all that and comes and adds one, and it goes. So from the beginning, if I reset it, you will see that it will be 0. And it adds up. So 0, 1, 2, 3 is just printing. So in this code, I've demonstrated to print text and also print a number, an integer as a variable. So this is a text and this is a variable. And the loop will continue increases until it doesn't fit on the screen and it will overlap. But it is just a demonstration. Now here is a demonstration with a little larger screen so you can see it fully. And if you disconnect this, the light will be turned off. It's like that. You can read it easily. Thank you for watching. This was how to use LCD screen with ESP32 to display text or information. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I always try to answer and reply. And if you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, you may subscribe now.